This is the story about how my team won the OCE World Championship Series February Finals. Really quick, before getting on with the video, I would like to just say if you could please subscribe, it would mean the world to me. I'm at over 2k subscribers now, and my yearly goal is 10,000. So if you could do that, I would really, really appreciate it. First off, I'd like to explain how the tournament is structured. So we have a winner's bracket and a loser's bracket. This is what is known as a double elimination tournament. Winning through the winner's bracket progresses you through the next stage. If you are to lose, you will be put into the loser's bracket where you have one more chance to make it to that final. All matches are a best of three format, meaning you need to win at least two of the games to advance to the next round. The team that wins in the winner's bracket will go to the final, and the team that wins the loser's bracket will be their opponent. Now, the loser's bracket team must beat the winner's bracket team twice, as every team must lose twice to be eliminated. Now, let's take a ride on this journey. In round one, we were up against Team Balance, a team that we versed on the ladder before, and we were prepared to face. We were out to prove a point in this tournament, so we came out fierce in the early game, picking off some early kills and taking control of the bottom lane. We tied that off with a strong mid-game fight where the supports, Don and myself, helped our attacker Joe just dominate the enemy, and then with some good defense in the endgame, we were able to take the victory for the first game of the series, putting us up 1-0 against Team Balance and ready to go into game 2. Coming off the confidence of such a dominant win, we showed the same aggression in lane in game 2. And then heading into the late game, we were in a really good position. In the Zapdos fight, I made a choice to zone off two of the enemies to allow Joe to run rampant and completely dominate the fight. Joe played his heart out in this tournament. Things did get a little sketchy towards the end though, as I went down, but Joe was able to get a clutch secure on the Zapdos, leading us to win the first round 2-0 and head into round 2. In round 2, we were up against the Kings of Degen. In the first game, our bottom lane came out with the same aggression, showing that we wanted to win at this tournament. Through some really strong fights at the Zapdos, we looked like that was going to be the case. Then things got a little scary when they flipped the Zapdos on us and got the secure. So I made a desperate last second attempt to get some points in. In scoring this 50, I was luckily able to secure us the win for this game and put us up 1-0 against Kings of Degen and head into a second game. In game 2, we were really confident. We came out strong and pushed into the bot lane. Through the late game, we started to push them so hard, they weren't even able to sit on their second goal. Though we got a little too confident and pushed a little too far. In this, they were able to wipe us out and secure the Zapdos, and we suffered our first loss of the tournament. We had to win the next game or it was off to the loser's bracket. We once again came out dominating the early game, though we'd given them some confidence, and they were pushing us really hard, but we were not gonna go down without a fight. We came through in the mid game with a really strong push, turning the game around, showing that we were not gonna go down easily. Then in the Zapdos fight, the boys absolutely popped off. This is one of the strongest fights we've ever had. We completely dominated this. We played perfectly and like true champions. I was so proud of the team. We were able to secure the Zapdos and put them on the back end, but the boys weren't done here. They popped off so hard that they killed them at their base as they spawned after the Zapdos. We were here to prove that we were serious, and in this game we showed that we were not here to play around. Winning this series against Kings of Degen 2-1, it was off to the next round. Now going into round 3, we were up against Leftovers, a team of some really good friends of ours and some names on the OWL roster. Now even though we were playing against our friends, this was not a friendly match, so we came out with that same early game aggression, and through the mid game, we were spreading our presence across the entire map. In the late game fight, we were able to push them into the bottom lane and fight them where we wanted them. This allowed us to push up the lane and not rely on getting Zapdos for a victory. We were able to score on their tier 2 goals and push our lead really far ahead. Though they did try to get the Zapdos, but once again, Joe clutched up, and we won the game, putting us up 1-0 in this series. It was now time to head into Game 2. In Game 2, we came out with the same aggression. We wanted to show that we respected our friends as competition. We were able to push the bottom lane really hard and dominate the game again, scoring into their base, not relying on the Zapdos for a victory. They again did try to flip the Zapdos, but you guessed it, Joe clutched up once again, giving us the victory in this series, taking it to 2-0, and it was off to the winner's bracket final. In the winner's bracket final, we were up against a team named iClan. This is a team from New Zealand that we versed on the ladder before. They had gotten to this point without dropping a single game, so we had to respect our opponents and take this game seriously. The bottom lane started out really neck and neck. Tensions were high, though we were able to swing this game into our favor. And heading into the Zapdos fight, we were confident. We started pushing them out and we hard won this fight, though we got a little too confident and I ended up getting out of position. I helped my team do damage to the Zapdos when I should have been zoning the Venusaur running down, and because of that they were able to get the steal. I did my best to make up for my mistake by making a late game push and scoring 100 points. Though that wasn't enough. We'd suffered a loss and I had thrown the game. It was time for Game 2 and we were going in at a disadvantage. In Game 2, I'd felt like I'd let my team down and it was showing in my play. I was being bullied in this game and I was not performing well. And because of that, our team was being dominated all over the map. My confidence had been shot. Though right before the Zapdos fight, the boys hyped me up and I fed off of their energy. I absolutely love these guys. I was moving in ways I hadn't moved in this entire tournament. I was juking and singing and cue charming and just dominating the enemy team. They gave me a fire that I hadn't had in a while. After that fight, the boys were going for the Zapdos and I was not gonna make the same mistake again. I put my life in the way of this Slowbro. I was not going to make that same mistake. I was not letting them through. And with just a sliver of health, I was able to keep them off the entire time, allowing our team to get the Zapdos and make this comeback. It was now 1-1, going into Game 3. In this game, tensions were high. Both teams really wanted that advantage heading into the grand final. Though we were fired up and we were making our presence known around the map, breaking their goals and asserting true dominance. The boys really played well in this game. When it came to the Zap fight, they were popping off and I did my best to just support them and let them do what they do. Though after the Zap fight, a call was made to score. We didn't want to risk the Zapdos, so we went to their base. Don scored 50 in the bottom and I scored 30 in their base. Though they did run down the Zapdos and they were able to flip it on us. So we were starting to panic. They were looking to score, but we managed to hold them off pretty well, even though some got through. At this point, we didn't know who was winning this game, and we were holding onto our hearts, trying to make a late game push, but unable to. And it turned out that those scores from Don and I won us this series and secured us a place in the grand final. After winning that series 2-1, it was time for the grand final, and we were up against FYB. FYB is a team we have versed plenty of times. I made a video about our experience against them in the qualifiers for this tournament. Check that out if you want to see more. The first game didn't start off the greatest. We had been on a couple hour break waiting for this game, but by the time for first Dreadnought, we were warmed up and the boys were ready to show that we meant business. We were pushing them so hard, dominating the game and scoring on their goals. They were not able to play. We had the intent of winning this game and taking this series. When it came to the Zapdos fight, FYB put up a really good fight. This was really neck and neck, but I was luckily able to get out and reset. meaning that we were able to take a second fight. Taking the second fight, we were able to push them out. We didn't want to rely on Zapdos to win. We wanted to show that we could do it without it. We don't want to take risks if we don't need to. So after taking them out, we pushed up to the top goal and we scored on their second goal, securing game one and giving us a chance to win this entire tournament in the next game. Being up against FYB 1-0 gave us a bit of confidence. Maybe a little too much confidence, as they picked me off early in the second game. Though, we started to turn things around in the mid-game, making some really big plays to get our team back in the driver's seat. Though we were being far too lax about this game, this was the game that would win the tournament, and we got caught out of position during the Zapdos fight, and they were able to punish us for it, allowing them to rip the Zapdos, securing it. And just like that, the series was even. It was 1-1, though they did have to beat us in a whole nother set, but we didn't want to rely on that. We wanted to shut this out. We wanted to take game three. We came out to play this game. We were pushing onto their second goal before the halfway point of the match. We were not only pushing on this goal, we were wiping them out. And we were breaking it. We were starving them all across the map. We were taking objectives from them. We were out to prove a point. At 2 minutes 30, we made an interesting decision to hard push onto their top goal. We did not want to rely on a Zapdos for this win. We wanted this to be a complete shutout. When it came time for the Zapdos fight, we were at a Unite move disadvantage, but we still took the fight and we played it well. We were playing around them and they were actually starting to pressure us, but Joe was popping off. Don and I were supporting him and we were able to just keep them crushed one by one. We were not messing around, and with that, we were able to take the Zapdos. Knowing the game was over, the enemy team surrendered, and just like that, we had done it. We had become the first ever OCE World Championship Series monthly champions. And we showed that we are a serious contender for the World Championships. I want to say a good game to everyone we played in this tournament. You guys showed up. You guys played your hearts out, and we are so happy to share a region with you. As always, guys, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and have a wonderful day.